Alright, welcome to the Flash animation tutorial. So what you're gonna need for this animation is a working version of Adobe Flash. I have Adobe Flash CS3 Professional, but there is a newer version out there, Flash CS4, and you can download that at the Adobe website. I'll put the link up in the description. So just start up Flash. So the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna make a new file. And before I'm gonna teach you actual animation, I'm gonna teach you some basic tricks with Flash. The first thing is motion tweening. So you're gonna draw a shape, you click it, convert it to a symbol, and you click F8 to convert it to a symbol. And you go to the timeline, right click, say insert keyframe, right click, say create motion tween. And what you can do now is you can move the object, and it's going to make an animation of the object moving. And other things you can do with a motion tween are you can make it change color. It's going to change from black to green. And you can make it change transparency. And you can do a bunch of other stuff. There are two types of tweens in Flash. There is a motion tween and there is a shape tween. And with the shape tween, what a shape tween does, it tweens shapes. So you can get an effect like this. Alright, so now that you know some basic tricks, we can actually get started on animating. So come over here, select the brush tool, be sure that you have a keyframe up there, and draw a stick figure. It's too big. There you go. Stick figure. What we're gonna do is we're gonna make him walk. So you insert a blank keyframe, you make sure that the onion skinning is on, because that shows you your previous frame. So these are the three steps we're gonna do. See, it's lifting up, your arms are coming down, because they're gonna swing. So you insert another keyframe. And it's coming up even further, and your arms are coming down. And now you're gonna have the little kicking. See? Your back foot is gonna kick through the front foot. Your arms are swinging. And here's the actual kick. So what you're gonna need now is the landing. So now the back foot is the front foot, as you can see, and it's gonna land on the ground like this. So here's the basic animation of that, and of course we're gonna make another step. Same process, and here's our walk cycle. Now you might have noticed that our little stick guy is headless. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna come up here, you're gonna create a new layer, and you're gonna draw a head. And what you do with the head is you just move it to the animation, like so. And it's easier to draw a head in a separate layer, because then you don't have to mess with erasing and drawing the head, or copying and pasting the head, and going through all that not necessary crap. Here's our stick guy walking. And of course, stick figures do more than just walk, they can run. And running is similar to walking, except it's a bit faster, and instead of normal kicking action, what you get is a little jump. So when a stick guy runs, First of all, it's faster. Instead of making two frames for actual lift and two frames for the kick, you make one frame for everything. And what you're gonna do now is you're gonna make him jump, because that's what people who walk, who run do. Running isn't just fast walking, it's different than walking. And what you want to remember with animations is that you want to over-exaggerate everything. See, I actually made him like do a long, not a long, like a kind of a high jump that you wouldn't do in real life. But in animations, you want to exaggerate these things. Here's our running. And you're going to use the same process to add the head on. I'm not going to do that right now. So, just think about physics. Like, if you're going to make a jump, here's what a jump would look like. See, he's going to bend his knees, like, because that's what people do when they try to jump. Except, because this is an animation, you're going to over-exaggerate that. You're going to make him bend his knees, like, all the way down. And you're going to anticipate it, so your viewer, the person who's watching the animation, expects the stick figure to jump. So when it actually jumps, the viewer will have a better time accepting the fact that the stick figure jumped. And what happens when you jump is that there is gravity, so the stick figure is going to slow down, and because of inertia, his legs are going to swing up. So you got to be thinking about all these physics when you're making an animation. You're going to think about what would happen if this were real. See? His legs swing up. Now he's going to slow down because of gravity. He's gonna fall, also because of gravity. So since he jumped like in a little angle, it's gonna be a curve. He's not gonna fall straight down, he's gonna fall in a curve. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna make him fall in a curve, like this. Here's our animation. So now is the moment that we've all been waiting for, the stick fight. Have this guy, and in the other layer, and you want to make sure that you have two layers for separate stickmen, because you don't want them to be in one layer. So I'm gonna make this guy attack this guy. They're not level. I'm gonna level them. There we go. So you're gonna combine all the techniques that we've learned. Well, not all, just the jumping, and I'm gonna teach you a new one. You wanna insert frames so you have some space to work with here, and he's gonna bend his knees, because that's what people do when they jump. And he's gonna get his fist ready, because he's preparing to punch this guy. Fist is getting bigger, and he's anticipating the attack right now. And as you can see, his fist is over-exaggerated, and that's because that's what animators do to make the animation more convincing. And he jumps, and what he's gonna do now is gonna punch. And see, I'm making the fist extra long, because again, I wanna over-exaggerate. Okay, there we go. So this is the punch, and now we're gonna animate the other guy getting punched. So this is where the animation happens. And you gotta remember that if you're gonna make an actual animation, there's gonna be a head here. So he's punching a head. So what happens now is this. And see, again, I made him a little longer to over-exaggerate the effect. So here's our punch. And you can add sound effects to that, of course. So, yeah, that's the basic animation. I'm gonna upload more tutorials about 3D perspective animation and some more effects and more fighting moves. So stay tuned and subscribe. Thanks for watching.